don't think that's gonna work with this one. I don't know, I'm not late chat, you are. Is it? No, stuff's getting cut off. Alright, it's not gonna work with this one. We're gonna have to stick to this one then. Unfortunate. Game's a bit too big in terms of screen occupation, you could say. It's a bit too big for how much it occupies the screen we're looking at. Alright, before we get into it, continuing, which I don't think it'll be too long today, because I'm tired. I'm not gonna lie, it's been a long day. So, check audio, and then we're gonna get right into it. Okay. I couldn't hear a damn thing. Hold on, give me a second. There we go. Alright. It was about time for their first meeting. Load? Yes. We're meeting Kaye for the first time. That's what we're doing. Well, for this point in the story, we already know Kaye is, obviously, but in terms of, like, the story being told, it's like, oh, their first meeting. My casualties changed a lot. One day, I basically spent in Kaye's basement room, coming back from home just to sleep. One time I got so lazy that I didn't feel like walking home, so I asked if I can spend the night here. It's dangerous at night. You can't. Wasn't that you who said it's about to spend a whole day in a room like that? You need to get some fresh air, at least at night. And so I wasn't allowed to stay. Job is boringly easy. Foolish stuff, sometimes walks around the room on prostheses, talks with no real topic. Wiping the body is the only thing of concern. And care about the lower part. Shizu-san. Give me that leg prosthesis. Let's decide like that. He tools to the bathroom on his own. The empty days kept coming and going. Month passed like nothing. Seeing my first salary, I got worried if I should actually take this much. The job is supposed to be hard. But it's so fun. I become afraid of some ancient misfortunes. I get nervous. I then started crumbling. Noticed it myself. Kayla's lonesomeness in my room began invoking gloom. Small but beloved home now didn't seem so wonderful. My ideal became that. You don't want anyone to disturb you. Stay in that underground room. From the time I found out about it, this apartment became nothing more than a place to stay the night. Rootless darts appear on a ball in the palace. Its own life begins to feel empty. I switch on the TV and lie on my bed. A stream of uninteresting news, remembering today's underground. Ishida-san, you're not living up to the meaning of your surname, Stone Staff. It pisses me off. What do you think he is? Think sometimes, seriously hating the spoiled boy. Well, of course, I care about him in words and works, and doesn't even care what I'll think. I thought you were more cruel. What? You're kind. You care about me. I'm defective. I feel human. That's how you are. Nice cold attitude. Damn masochist. I see the power I don't have in how Kaye doesn't care if he's treated like a thing. How he acts decently without getting stuck on any words of others. Why would you try being next to someone you didn't become? Next to someone you're in awe with. You're probably waiting for a crumb to be spared for you. Nothing new. Damn, it's like tightrope walking. When balance is lost, you need to fix it in cold blood. If you jerk to the wrong side, you fall. It's alright. I'll carefully return to my place, with the feeling that I want to keep taking care of him for as long as I can. In that basement room, I can't get off my mind. What was just a temporary poisoning? Same as with a balancer. 1 month will pass, fever should cool down. Yeah, something like that. Oh. music is banger. It's not obviously, it's not their own tracks. I learned the hard way. But it doesn't stop the music from still being just really good. It gets really good. Well, that hopeful force I was naive. Complicating the illness, fear didn't cool down. It kept heating up. It's unpleasant to admit, but this is life. Once fortune turns away from you, it keeps going against you again and again. Ah, yes. Shisa-san, your house is in the north part of Shikura, right? Yes, why? You want to go shopping? I want to see with my own two eyes if you reach it. Shisa-san, did you know? The world of rock and roll has condensed to this hole. Apparently in a nice mood, Kai put on a prosthesis of legs and left hand today. Probably that's why. The first time I saw his theatrical gesture. What's rock and roll, a fossil? Close a comic book. So he'll buy some books to kill time, so I bought him some comic books as well. Guy doesn't read at all. These books are permanently borrowed by me. We have plans to persuade him into buying some Gokushi, but that's a secret. Hey, why are we bringing up fossils now? Why are we bringing up fossils now? It's a physical form of an object. It looks like a stone. Oh. It looks like a stone. Wait. Shisa-san, do you not listen to music? No, when I play myself, it's alright. I don't like listening to others' music. Hmm, so you don't know about rock and roll either. So anyway, youngsters from Shikura North said you can get some drugs of unavailable in pharmacies for a decent price. What? Suddenly, well, it doesn't matter though. The underground devil continues. But yeah, it's not that cool. Like marketeers doing his best. Youngsters under 20 keep on raving. Dealers don't just sell drugs, they're extorting ones that fail to pay the price. Giving them a showy lesson, they know their stuff. Those are the guys that owe a lot of getting car accidents. But it's a hit and run, you can't catch them. A detective I know complained to me about that. Doesn't concern me at all, but that story resembles the book I just read. Listen, I don't know, is this going to end once they know that the business is just a cover? Want to dream? There. Get Triazolma. That'd be decent and dealt with. You won't have too many permanent clients either, right? If you try to disturb it too much, you get caught. That's not fun. Yeah, but the problem is he isn't getting caught. Like marketeer, of course. He'll show up himself. But his cases are imitations. He's learning from the long-lasting and successfully ending small dealers' cases that imitates them. So inspectors can't make out criminal's image. A weird topic. Actually, who would know imitational crimes better than me? Even still, if the criminal doesn't leave someone's image, you can't see his true face. His discerning feature is, no matter how laughable it is, lack of face. Strange criminals. What are they trying to achieve by imitating? Who knows? Well, not taking anyone's place at least. That's the deal anyway. I thought you knew something, Ichida-san. Your character is the one that usually catches on topics like that. Come on. You think any black marketeer would come close to that building? Oh. The answer is no, but it wouldn't. I got it. I live in Building 13. The one that mother's scared of priest's children with. Fame was high danger and poverty levels. Well, I surprisingly like the topic, though. Having fun, Ichida-san? You know something after all. Nope, I honestly don't. But just now, you were worried about me, right? That was like a warning. Don't get caught up in it. Kind of didn't move an eyebrow. Why? I'm interested in criminals' copycats. What happens to you is none of my concern. Black Dog barked. Come here, hold on. There we go. Nevertheless, the days were busy. 5 months passed since I got discharged from that clinic. This show will end in favorable wins as well. I think optimistically on the way home. The guy in the basement was, as usual, indifferent to my fate. Little I'm thinking that it's alright. If it gets too hard to bear, I'll make him obey with power. Oh, Harika-chan! Nijima-chan was waiting for me near the door. Ding, reacts, my hand and lately relaxed radar. Something happened? Someone was in your room until recently. You don't come back until 7, right? I thought it strange, so I went to look and some strange boy came out of it. He said he knows you from the clinic and that I shouldn't worry, and went his way. What? That's it? Nothing else happened? I'm telling you, no. But it's the first time I saw anyone come for you, Harika-chan. Of course. I didn't say I got discharged from any of my acquaintances. Thank Nijima-chan and go in. Shit, what for? Why? I don't get it. The room was a fine example of an apartment after a search. Bed and TV are untouched, so I sit on the bed and think. We might have been. Can't think of anyone, of course. I'm gonna change the door locks first thing in the morning tomorrow. What the hell? Home invasion? You don't get why? That's something I keep on hearing today. Next day, 2 PM. Doorstop took some time, so I came late to work. I'm gonna satiate it from just juice. I cut an apple for Kai. Eat some grape myself. Single-handed apple cutting is a trick I learned especially for Kai. Listen, I'm serious. Yesterday I came home and it was all turned upside down. I didn't do anything at all that would make me any enemy after discharge. Consulting with him. What did I mean? Kai opens his mouth. Kai opens his mouth. Carefully feed him apples an apple slice. Naftan proceeds to lay it on the table. So he doesn't feel like wearing it today. He was just a burglar? Nothing was stolen. I'm going to carry my paybook with me, and I carry all my money with me. If anyone sees my profit, I'm done for. Well, there's no meaning to think about it, I guess. You don't remember what happened that day. You don't know what you did yesterday, right? Well, something like that. But, hey, really sad to Kai? Thanks, you can clean up now. Take your tray and go to the sink. Since there's no sink in this room, I have to wash dishes in the toilet room. One of us was cubic and this room has two. Square walls had different colors in them. Then the one leading to the forest is a toilet without a door. One door except the south one, are mysterious and locked. Oh. Why are there two cups in the sink? Why do I need to ask why? Today, before I came, he had a guest. Hey! Hey! Anyone come? I shout, washing the fruit knife and plate. What? You introduced me to him yourself. He said he needs help and wants, no matter what, to ask me something. I shut off the water, drop the fruit knife in my pocket, and as naturally as I can, return to the room. What was he like, so that I can remember him? A bit younger than you. His name was Isari Shinya. Isari Shinya? You know him? Of course I do. How can I not? Why him? Was he discharged already? He's sudden, as usual, and... What are we talking about? Well, the hot topic. He wants revenge against his sister. Now he was caught. I heard about it. Isari Shinya, high schooler, left parents to die and tried to kill his sister. Well, all that was 3 years ago. He should be in a clinic now. He managed to leave the clinic, and he probably cut his eye teeth, and he wouldn't think about revenge. What did you do, Kai? Whatever I said, my words didn't reach him at all. You know it, right? The rumor people made up, want to kill a possessed, ask a demon from the forest. That's about me. Asari-san sadly took it seriously. The fish is running about above the ceiling. Like dog snuffles loudly. First time I hear about a rumor like that. If it's that guy, he might take a rumor like that seriously. I see, so Shinzo the sister is possessed. He decided to carry out revenge for sure. What did you suggest? To dig a hole for someone more carefully, nothing more. Asari Shinya has both legs and arms. Even offer a hand prosthesis. That's how he wants to have his revenge. If all he wants to kill, of course. Black dog. It wants coming close to me, rubs against my leg. Good grief. Good grief. What time did he come? About an hour before you came. We know each other. I can't leave such a dangerous guy alone. So, is it okay if I leave early today? I have to catch Asari Shinya. I'll be alright. When it comes to a fight, I can't do much with one hand. Okay. Wait. You can take the prosthesis from the table, as you don't have your own feelings yet. You can only use this one. I don't get it. Prosthesis are for left hand. One on the table? Take it. Don't be shy. You wanted a hand prosthesis from the very beginning, didn't you? Yeah. Okay. I'll take it then. Why would I need it, though? Can't refuse after those words from him. Taking the white left hand that I don't even want to touch. It won't even fit me. I'll leave the basement room. Nowhere to search. Say it straight. We changed in 3 years to Sari Shinya's house on land tenure in Nozu. Return to the station and take a bus to Nozu. Sometimes since my discharge, I go there. I don't feel like showing myself too much. In the bus, I decided to put on the prosthesis lent by Kai. It's made to match him perfectly. I tried to think about it, but I noticed prosthesis is wonderful. No tricks. Just had to put white artificial arm close to me. Put D white artificial arm close to me for it to grow in perfectly. It's not moving, of course. The wonderful part in it is that Kai can move it like a god. Seriously, what's the trick? I mumble as the bus keeps going. Soon I arrive to Nozu. Day is closing to dusk. One of the Shikura City's horrors. Illusionary high-rise building jerks with red light. Sorry, building free, room 303. No nameplate. Let no new family went in. Apartment left after possessed. Who's gonna use it? The door I enter. I don't want him to run away, so I squeezed in without ringing the bell on the door. It sounds completely empty. So, houses in Nozu are RLDK. So it was a bit tight here. It was just above right size for a mother, a father, and a sister, and a brother to live together. Sun sets. Look at the balcony from the empty living room. Said so. He's not here, I don't know how to find him. I don't want to, but I'll have to. I'll go back to call clinic and ask the staff about his discharge. One was so perfect. It's like what I asked for. It's 10th hour in the evening. Came back from Nozu and was in front of building 13. Back of my head suddenly got hit with a blunt object. Ow. Kinda rude. I see sparks in my eyes. Didn't lose consciousness, but I almost fell face down. Not that any time to collect myself, I get kicked in my back and fall to the ground. Hey! You're Ishiza Arika? Who grabs my hand and drags me into darkness? What the hell? So hope is in front of me. Isn't anyone coming to help? Hey, is that the guy? What the fuck? He's weaker than us. He's the one chasing us to the corner? More sparks. I mean, my head was kicked from the side. Can't deal with the situation anymore. More than three. Less than six kids pushed me to a big tree. Hey, you're alive? You're alive, right? Well, I don't care though. Takun? Can I hit him too? Why not? See, he's not bleeding. Just to hit his face. If you hit it too strong, he's gonna kick the bucket. They laugh. A loud hit to the back of my head. It probably hit me with a swing, like playing golf. Are you stupid or what? The back of the head is the vital... yuck, blood! Stop it, he's gonna kick in like that! What if he dies? He's useless anyway. Ah, right, he's possessed. He's fine without a head, too. The lynching begins. The hands bent, turned to Samba as well as verbally abused. All the incoming hits, I start getting interruptions in my consciousness. I don't see the faces anymore. I don't understand the words. Left hand. Prosthesis moves. Blood richly flows into it. What? Takun, what's with your hand? Started yelling right after the question. Come on. So that infamy. Right. Right in front of my eyes. Such a house, no one came out to help. Anger. Is there about some weakling counter-striking? Attacking with a crowd. It's reached with an overwhelming difference in power. Grand defiance, abuse, groans, and grinding teeth.
I'm sorry.
Pleads to the last woman around my age. Caused me to burst in laughter. I admit, I really don't like using brute force. But sadism after masochism is very, very nice. I barely contain my laughter. Five youngsters, or six, lie on the ground, soaked in blood, but they're fine. Oh damn, well, but they're still alive. A slight regret. What's that? I start a new life at last. I can live as a normal human. It wasn't long before I crossed the border of allowed self-defense. I should be more careful here. Didn't make all that time back to the clinic. But it was fun. So fun, I can't do anything about it. Yes, yes! To put a human in this mental state to a clinic is a crime! They're the ones responsible, too. Hey, Takun! Want an ambulance? No? Weird guy? You're wheezing something. Can't understand ya. Even like that, two are probably going to die. One's going to pass by soon anyway. The frailty that made them attack on the roadside became a straw that would save those Takuns. That's great. Even one of you died, and this whole thing made it to public. Not to lie low. And like that, we both are lucky. What a shame. Can't control my face expression because of the excess happiness. What am I standing here for? I'd better go home. Sometimes, Rika, you're a bit fucked, man. Hi, hi, my home. I'm back. You know, I got into some trouble on the way here. I made it all right from Nozu. Got the door closed, switched TV on, and fall in the bed. The new stream makes me refuse to believe my ears. What? Gentlemen, but look at the screen. What's my imagination? Perpetually announcing news from another world speaker names familiar places and names. Today, at around 6 o'clock, in the industrial area of Nozu in Shikura City, in the western array, a body of a young man was found, identified as Hisari Shunya, 19 years old, living in said place. By the words of witnesses and Hisari's notes, accused him when his death is being seen there at the time of... What the hell? My mind gets empty this time. I come back to the senses from the board of the consciousness. Why is it me who killed him? Now the one accused of killing Hisari Shinya. It's none other than... none other but my own. Huh? The fuck? We weren't even near the incidents. Whatever I did, nothing worked out well. Deal girl, though. To my mind grades. A model student. Look at it that way. Everyone around me was so scared of me, they wished me death. I know why. Yeah. Because whatever I finished doing, the finish was different from other kids. From casual walk to corner store to talks with parents, from school stuff to healthcare. I couldn't stop if things didn't seem to work out the best I could think of. Every time my parents were disappointed in me, but I succeeded. They were saying, well done. That's how everything ended. Restoration, of course, was successful and failed. It resulted in my own way. Made many suffer at the same time. No one blames me, because pros are overrated. Sometimes this relation is going to turn around. But I didn't know any other ways. My dad was scolding me. Don't do anything. I was completely weird. Mother admitted that I'm a pain in the ass. Couldn't correct myself. Desperate. I was depressed and couldn't even go out. The way I was holding the spoon was scary. What my mother taught me. I'm afraid of my actions, I should just completely copy someone else's. And I'll do just fine. And so, in the end, I didn't know how to stop myself. She... Let's see. Adjust my seat. Ishizu Rika-san, my congratulations. This game showed you are latent. Your healing course as an agonist syndrome carrier is over. That's making your acquaintance for the past half year. Half a year after entering clinic, July 2003. ECG, pulse, ABB, ABP, notice the cerebral membrane of inner nerve and other insides of mind related and accounted. My innocence proven. Only Mato-san, glaring at me from the other side of the glass door, was unhappy. Thank you very much. And I get discharged, my conscience clear? No, Ishizu-san, you were wounded by a syndrome carrier. We're going on to next procedures. We'll be examining you just like before, but we'll transfer you to a normal chamber. Looks like not possessed discharge, then. Doesn't work here. The old tomato nods in satisfaction. Sparring with her for so long. Good at that, but Mato-san is even better at pressuring. That's crossing the line. What kind of human is she? Tormenting me like that. The Mato should have told you the details. Well, here's your new schedule. Your case, Ishizu-san, is new for us, so we want to deal with the procedure especially carefully. What ace personnel consists of a decent amount of real doctors. This one quite friendly, with some documents sounding a contract in front of me. Ah, sign right here, right. That pen in my hand, I freeze. See my new schedule. Half a day takes going through doctor's rooms from top to bottom of Ward A. Second half. Talk with other patients. Keep yourself in shape, and that finishes with a romantic, psychological high-class examination by Dr. Toma herself. Which I nearly believe was last today. Pardon me, question. What's all this service in this clinic? Am I not the one to be served, being a patient? You see, thing is, even though you're mentally injured, you're still a healthy man, right? That's why, as part of a real rehabilitation in the society, this way of curing is also effective. Well, I mean, one room with clinic's patients, talk to them, walk with them, work to the seventh sweat, and rehabilitate on their way. It seems. Don't care about my safety. Their top priority is immediate results. Or it won't make sense for me to risk my life. Do I have the right to refuse in some particular cases? Well, actually, Dr. Toma asked to tell you. as to tell you, it's not a voluntary job. It's a system. This human is pitiful, so confused. By the way, most lethal cases in this clinic were not brought failed surgeries. They were brought by aggression explosions caused by awkward communication of patients. Gotcha. By the way, doctor, I want to just confirm, this service is voluntary, right? Yes, in a sense. You could maybe call it loyalty or junshi. Got it. Mostly it'll take long before discharge. I mean, I can't get out alive because of Mato-san's beliefs. Getting out dead, sure. Possibly tomorrow? 50-50 chance. Meaning? Abandon all hope. I'm meditating a bit and left the chamber and met Mato-san, waiting for me. She had no white coat, even now, I guess. Shosai, let me tell you from the start, nothing's voluntary. Leaking private conversations. Okay, got it, it's forced. Yep. You have a role, I treat you as a human. Well, it's okay not to get too embarked in your job. You're such a numbskull, you go dancing on a minefield. Well, see ya. Until next week. Evil Tomato bids me goodbye. So a note down. Careful, next week brings despair. Nevertheless, still got a bit of freedom to walk around the building. First thing first, I went to Dr. Doodlin's confessional. Dr. Doodlin, also called Dr. Kinui, is always silent with patients that are bothered by anything. There's nothing to be sort of desperate about. I think you should instead build up hope. In your case, Erika-kun, your sister was sent to Ward D, so clearly it can't just discharge you saying no problems, even if you're latent. That decision was made in half a year, not because Dr. Toma gave it all her effort. Well, yeah. Quoting Mato-san, good for you, even if you're pressured till half-death, you'll forget everything at night. So it's right. So I guess she'll happily put her efforts on all sides. Look at expert Tomamato, nicknamed Mato-san. I possessed this or started raging about, you got her tied up before everyone around could suffer. Saved my life. What the hell? Okay. Back to it. Saved my life. Now I found out she's a medical expert police inspector, public safety elite, ordered to inspect A syndrome carriers. Hardworking woman. Often shows up in clinic and inspects patients. Sometimes drags in new ones. Harika-kun, your memory doesn't hold daily events through night, right? Could you please tell me at what hour do they disappear? At morning. Surprisingly, it depends on my mood. Well, at average. Lose memory from half till 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. And if I don't watch the time, I forget everything when sun sets. And the opposite, I can remember events from evening till morning. It's important to know that, so I can live with it somehow. Write down important stuff that happened during the day. Read the notes at night, and that's it. So I'm just writing down text. Every image depending information is a bit inaccurate. What a mess. From one side, your frustrations are erased, but you can live with no problems. That's why Toma doesn't want to let you out. Toma, you want to heal Arika-kun's injured memory, right? Not really. Just tired with all that torturing. I won't believe that. Erika-kun, do you think she's tired with torturing? A warning smile. So I got to know the unpleasant truth. Gotcha, I was stupid. By the way, Doc, if I get free time tomorrow, is there anything for me to do? Read a book? No, reading's not for you. Needless to read during the day. Forget it anyway. I'm going to read and do it at night. Yeah, but somehow that's a great fortune. Maybe you'll paint during the day. Everything will be left on the canvas, then resume painting. Shouldn't be so hard. Well, that's right too. Is it fun to paint? The more serious you are about it, the more of a headache it becomes. Arika-kun, did you draw anything as a kid? Yuno brings dusty painting utensils. Oh yeah, I remember drawing some scribbles some time ago. Not for getting praise, not to show it to anyone, or just playing with a paintbrush. Can you avoid unpleasant recollections if you don't have any gold to begin with? Waiting room of Ward B is an atelier, chessboard. I need to find a place in the clinic with a view to an inner garden. So, I was moving my paintbrush here and there. An interesting person talked to me. And that's you. Hey, sorry. Or Haori, there you are.
Sorry, you didn't mind if I stick around?
The person introduced to me as Hisari Shinya sat on the floor and kept looking at me with a nitpicking glare. Like a critter that met a human for the first time in its life. Keep watching my every movement with shimmering eyes. Full of hellish miasmas, the person didn't seem to have any evil intentions, so I started talking in a relaxed manner.
Is it possible to be so agile at handling everything in one hand?
I don't have the other one, so I'm doing my best.
I giggled, and so did Hisari. Hisari appeared to be quite a normal person, talked to me about stuff with no particular topic, and so became my friend.
I remember clearly how Hisari liked my hand. I don't have the left one, so I only have the right one left. So I kept on watching it, probably because...
Oh, because you're missing their right hand.
Hi there, Shizu-san. Shogi today?
Half a year passed. It's now the beginning of the summer of 2003. Getting in a boring mess in the clinic, I had my discharge delayed until summer. Not enough for me to patient appears before me.
Are you alright? It's me, Hisari.
Hisari?
Alright. According to my notes, this person before me looks like Hisari Shinya. When I met during
days, I have no image recollections of. I believe it's the case, because I actually know the old body features. Hair length, height, build, and gender. My condition was delayed because the Hisari in front of me has changed drastically, being a new feature.
What switcher did you fall? How that? That's after surgery. Everything was bad there from long ago, so I just told him to amputate it.
A single-handed patient, just like me. From this day on, Hisari doesn't have a right hand.
We talked for a while.
Music sounds. Personal time is over. Hisari says goodbye and leaves.
Oh, hi, Arika-kun.
That moment, Dr. Doolittle greets me, passing by at the same time.
A great guy.
He answers anything you ask him.
Hey, Doc. Is Hisari already getting discharged?
Yeah, just like you, Arika-kun. Hisari's on good accounting, so discharged half a year early. Well, we had to discharge someone this month. If you behaved, we would have discharged you now.
Ha ha ha. Yeah, Mother-san was raging about. Looks like I'm going into isolation tomorrow again.
Well, tell me, what are Hisari-san's symptoms?
You know, Hisari is from Ward C. I didn't know it was anything out of the ordinary.
Hisari-san's modification is quite rare. Appearance has changed, but at the same time, you can't see the symptoms. Get what I mean?
I raised my hands.
Not at all.
You can see it, but can't see it. This is a weird puzzle. Actually, to be honest, I wasn't interested in Hisari's symptoms.
Face expression. Hisari-san's face, nerve cells, muscles, fibers can become something completely different. Hisari-san can, on own will, change face expression to match some image.
What? That's usual. If you get angry, your face gets angry.
Yeah? You don't really smile when angry, but Hisari-san is something different. Hisari-san makes sad face when angry. Can copy your manner to look lifeless as well.
What a weird modification.
We bought him with a cure anyway. Didn't just discharge Hisari right away. Nothing dangerous about that.
Well, that depends. To one living being, that power is not much, but that's quite a talent in society, don't you think? Even though it's hard to find an analogy. Guess what we're talking about is how fake smiles doesn't look fake is scary stuff. Medulla once met some wedding swindlers. Well, let's leave that modifications aside. What made Hazari possessed? I'm asking the main question right now. Or right away. That's what interests me. However normal Hazari can look, if one is here, one was definitely broken once. It's a relation of an unusual degree. Sao-san can't have a goal in life. Wants the power to objectively judge oneself. That would be more accurate. Can't even talk without copying anyone. Is that even the right place to cure that? Shouldn't Sao be sent to a psychiatric clinic before a purgatory? No. The problem, of course, is there. It doesn't mean Hisari-san becomes the copied human. In the end, Hisari Makina just takes someone else's life into account. So everything works out well. And then, Arika-kun, the facility you mentioned is her younger brother, Hisari Shinya. Years after being forced into a psychiatric hospital, cured with a 2.5-year-long psychiatric curse, Sashin at the age of 18 was put into accounting of defense forces, recognized as socially rehabilitated. Relatives agreed to accept Hisari Shinya. Note, coincidentally, his older sister, Hisari Makina, was discharged from Origa Clinic around the same time. No relatives agreed to shelter, so she made home at Municipal Welfare Organization of Shikura Town. Sarashina was officially recognized as a role model patient both by doctor in charge and by inspectors in charge. His mental and physical condition at best. And a doctor that knew of his condition at the time events took place was applauding to the 3 years effort of the hospital. Nevertheless, even the cure of Sarashina's statements about the case remained vague. At that time, his position was that Sarimakin was the criminal, and he was the victim. After a couple of days, after Hisari Makino was found an asymptomatic carrier, he recognized his mistake, and here's the current version. He didn't talk about his sister, Hisari Makino, after that. Two-year-long court examination announced the Hisari family case an accident. Half a year after discharge from health center, Hisari Shinya was found dead in a room in Nozu Industrial Area. Cause of death? Blood loss from a lacerated neck wound. 3 years passed from the time he lost his parents and pushed his sister from the third floor's balcony. What was he thinking? What was he fearing? No one can know anymore. Except the one whom he half a day earlier, in the underground room, told his story.
Oh. He told Kai everything? Why exactly is the question.
For what reason would he have to tell Kai anything? Like at all?
I really can't say.
I'll tell you about my sister. You listen?
Oh, you listen?
Now and once, I thought of my sister as a human. As a human. Now I have even a reason. While I was a child, it was strange, confusing. You know, my sister was so perfect, so ideal. Why was she so disgusting to me? Saying that question with a piece with Loki started his story. My sister raps and I pull out.
certain kanji of our names. My mother was saying that my name, Shinya, was born from my sister. Makina and Shinya. My parents wished we become a harmonic brother and sister. I wish so too, but my sister wasn't the type who could understand that human feeling. So your talent ripens only if the environment grows it properly. If you give modern weapons to barbarians, things will only get worse. This is a piece of family that didn't need a god. Sayuri Makina was a heavenly punishment for our house. Hey Shinya, your sister wants to be alone sometimes, right? Tell about that to mom and dad. Oh. Hey Shinya, your sister wants to be alone sometimes, right? Tell about that to mom and dad. Well, it's still possible to fix anything. Every time I went to play outside, my mother secretly whispered that to my ear. She was reminding me of that so much. I have that in my primary memory now. Since I only just entered conscious age, I always just tilted my head and didn't understand what she meant at all. At the same time, I loved my sister, and I was envious that everyone was so nice to her everywhere. I have frustration at my mother. My sister was so loved. Everyone in the area was greeting her. She looked like my sister with that alienated look. Yeah, Shinya-kun. You're Makina-chan's brother. She started to change when I started going to school. I was in the second grade. My homeroom teacher picked me out only because I was Makina's brother. He was her homeroom teacher last year. He wasn't a very diligent student a year ago. Didn't have much interest in study. I just had to memorize that. Just a game. Why would I be stubborn? Like I didn't have anything of a kid. My teacher didn't have anything of an adult. My games and studies as of something silly. So the teacher answered, "Memorize it all, or I won't let you in class." Next couple days, Makina didn't leave her room. We lived in the same room with sister before middle school, so I knew what was happening. Day and night, she was on the two-story bed, memorizing, just like teacher said. In some free days, Makina came back to class, memorizing by heart every second year textbook. That wasn't the end of it. It externally passed to next grade, reading information about authority and homeroom teacher's common sense. It stopped at six-year subjects. Why? Because student couldn't get further grade textbooks. Teacher made two mistakes. He gave Makina a goal. He told her that studying is memorizing. Fortunately, that around her were second graders. They understand what mad mess was Makina making. Girl that can study everything in one day. That's it. Really fortunate. A year later, she would be compared to me. For a year, the teacher was doing his best trying to make Makina a student. After some time, he could not bear it any longer and was forced to come to us. Your daughter is an incredibly talented student. Our school is not a place for her. I would recommend her to move her to a more advanced facility. And so on. If you transfer her, you'll write a recommendation. The school wouldn't bother looking for a more advanced facility. And we claim class at a school. Everyone also understood how strange Makina is. If I were a simply talented student, but transferring someone lacking the sense of humanity itself would make it their responsibility. The transfer has to be done by Hisari family's will alone, but Dad was always responding with this line. Different school means constant trips somewhere far. You don't have money for that. Our Makina is fine where she is now. So in line, Makina kept visiting So the line Makina kept visiting the little kitten society. Yes. Surely after that experience with my sister, of course he picked me out. By the way, after that teacher heard a rumor about me getting alienated from my class, he left school right away. He was a good guy. Coming to work in a cool car. At the end, he was writing some miserable junk. Students were laughing at him. He shut himself in his own world. After that, I remember my dad saw a newspaper, made an awkward face, and mumbled something about suicide and rope. The classmen were saying as a matter of course, because Makina took a dislike to him. You do. I don't want to think about it. Some of Machina's henchmen must be throwing something like, you have to get rid of your enemies. And after that case, I understood why was my mother saying what she was saying back then. You had some base knowledge of some area wouldn't know what's happening in it. Great innovative engine wouldn't impress ones that see cars simply as movement devices. To understand Machina's actions, you would need at least a tiny bit of her intelligence. Laugh at my bragging now, but I got to be the best in my class now too. I understood that I'm above average level. Yeah, and I had best grades until the first year of high school. I was quite talented. But I didn't have the time to feel my superiority. Fortunate or unfortunate, I didn't get to. So to say, I felt like an imp living next to Satan. I'm not careful, my self-confidence and everything else along with it crushed. That's all from my younger years. That's how Hisari Machina was. Machina was an amazing adult. What was she was said to do? God's child. Genius. There's no one knows that I didn't know her. If you look closer, she's doing everything without putting any effort. Still, she has come far further than anyone. So many people decide to ignore it. Doesn't look at the sun directly. Sis, you're not seriously trying hard, right?
Nope. Or else I've become completely alone.
The day before vacation, I sent a question to the direction of second story of the bed and got my answer. Weird answer. Malkin doesn't stand herself. Said I'll become completely alone. Been completely alone for a while now. She just didn't notice it. Dang. After passing Machina's school year, parents were harder and harder to look at. I understand that. They're praising her in words, but their faces say, "We don't need you, you're just a bother." That isn't strange. Machina succeeds in one thing, but makes others lose many other things. Money, for example. Machina gets highest grade in Sakura, but she consumes the whole family budget. She starts learning, she requires endless amount of material. She's buying books here and there, memorizes them, burns the ones she read for some reason. But it's literally vaporizing because of her. Poor man riding a limousine, gives both parents pride and the cause of the beggarly life with no money. At the same time, Machina was an unrivaled role model student. Parents couldn't scold her, treating her like a painful corn that desperately played love with the daughter. How heinous. Both parents meeting themselves before a fifth grader, a sister who believed their tormented smiles. She doesn't understand anything concerning herself. There's nothing she couldn't do, neither home nor at school. Say school's role is to teach how to teach oneself. Mother's role is to do housework, and father's role is to get money. She didn't need any of them anymore. I think she did everything herself. It was different when she was a child. Now the child is still bound by conventions of society. We were calming ourselves down, saying to ourselves that she's a child, but still we were afraid of the fact that she's less and less of a child every year. She was unrivaled, but she didn't have any allies. And still, Machina was a great older sister. How much I tried, I couldn't catch up with her. No matter how hard I studied, my good grades faded in comparison. It's an amazing barrier. Complex cancer case, always raining my mind. Not even once I thought of my sister as of a human. She's like a god. Inspiring amazing with her perfection and thrilled with her power. Gods are something like this, right? But one day, when Machina was in fifth grade, my goddess suddenly went crazy. Had to look a ghost! What if Machina calls dad. Tai doesn't react to her call. Me and mother don't hurry to her side either. Because the whole family is tired of Machina by now. Burning! Black like ash! Machina's interested voice at the balcony is calm. Maybe she's just joking. Maybe it's just her imagination. The tone of voice says that it's not necessary to run to her side. A girlish, cute voice. And by the way, Makino only talked in this voice that one time. Sometimes I get tormented by a thought. What if that was a desperate scream? The first time Makino ever asked her family for help.
I mean, it could be.
That'd be fucked up though. The one time she finally speaks up in an actual, like, normal voice. Or in somewhat normal voice. They just ignore it. Because if Dad pulled her back from balcony then, saved her, sister always went the wrong path. Never did misstep. And here. Makino was on the balcony until sunset and mother took her back to her room. The next day, during breakfast, Makino, as usual, smiled to mom and dad. Some awkward fake smiles in return and yelped a little. Heh. Unwillingly, I smiled too. Funny. She can do anything. She only just noticed that.
Oh. The illusion's broken?
And so Makino became a comedy hero. Realizing everyone's hate to her, she started trying so hard. Like it was a matter of life and death. She tried to return to the former world. The world she saw before. Everything in her usual way, showing off her genius. She was throwing herself out on everyone. Come on, be friends with me. It was already getting extreme, becoming a tragedy. Comes in to play with you when you're alone. No previous agreements. You see what she likes herself, what she finds and solves your problems. She'll also tell you about your faults and characteristics, all in details. Her acquaintances were more and more afraid of her. Makino didn't mind that and kept on dashing at a breakneck pace. She wanted to show herself a nice girl before neighbors. She was sucking up not just to her fellows, but to her parents as well. She kept on doing that in the scale of whole school, whole street blocks. Once decided she didn't know any other ways, she was getting the opposite result. A dancing doll with a head on fire. Wanted to make friends, you shouldn't be so forceful. Accepting complaints on a regular basis, like eating rice or drinking tea. Do something with your girl, please. She's weird. Every time Makino heard those complaints from her mother, she became more and more desperate. As usual, she brought her method to a dead point. I've had enough. You loony? Stop fooling in front of adults. Mother broke. Yeah. Cyril kept getting into the hurricanes Makino created, and then... Eddie, Makino clung to Dad. Dad was even more disappointed in her than Mom. Makino, stay at home now. A bad girl like you shouldn't do anything. Makino, my sister was no longer called Makino. Fake smiles erased from parents' faces. It was to say, everything Makino's still doing with her way. Dad stopped bringing her daughter to her administration house. Mother, who didn't look at me before, started being happy with her son's usual success. Only my name was leaving her mouth. Even at school, Makino was treated like an empty spot. She was ignored. Like she was invincible. Invisible. Sorry. It happened to me too. I made a victim out of myself and avoided that fate. That sad truth. I was always blind to my Makino's shine. I have to be on her side now? I never thought the same, probably. Let her be like that. A child. 4 years. From since Makino got in middle school, were the best years of my life. She just moved to a different room. Used before as a storage room, and the big room, where we lived together before, was just mine now. At the same time, Makino became lifeless, kept looking down at the floor. It was quite like a ghost. Mom or Dad tried talking to her, she yelped. Sometimes she looked in my direction with a lonely look, but I answered that with a fixed stare. She fled to her room right away. Makino's life collapsed. Everything around her was scary. She came to a dead end which she couldn't get out of from alone. Ugh. anything to do with Machina. Jinya, can you save her? You're her brother after all.
I feel like it, Mom. Push on me when you're lazy to do so yourself.
Alright, about food. Maybe she should eat alone in her room? That would be happy. Give her to call her for dinner every day is a bother.
Machina would gloomily sit in the corner of her room. Like a ghost. Isn't right. But who cares?
Okay, so this family just sucks. Got it. That's what I'm getting from this.
I kind of forgot how to do anything. The former Wonderkind became a shame of Hisari family. Of course, I had to deal with it.
Getting to the same middle school, I was studying as hard as I could. Because of that, powerless Machina was compared to me. Even at school, they didn't leave her alone.
Machina fled to my classroom a lot of times. I fixed my stare at her and she ran away again. I kept a distance from her at school. The other places, but I didn't really keep watch on it. I didn't really have to know of those places anyway. I didn't solve her problems and I didn't tell her parents about it. And so, Machina was ostracized from society.
Oh, finally. Managed to lock down a beast. Yes. I was always afraid. As I was in awe, the depths of my soul, I wished for her to be gone. Couldn't do anything about it.
Good lord. Yeah, she's a little misprofit and all, but I don't think she deserved all this, dude.
In high school, Machina kept skipping classes from the first semester. I stopped going there at all before summer vacation. Closed in a dark room, she only showed up for dinner. Last stage. Machina, day after that, losing her abilities, couldn't even talk normally anymore. Like a newborn child, she could forget how to breathe like that. So it happened that Mom was taking care of her. She even talked to Father about placing her to an orphanage. Of course, Father's answer was the same, as it always was. We don't have money for that. Deal with it yourself. I have exams to do. I was losing the last drops of her love to Machina. Became a topic for local rumors. Machina's care was getting close to the bottom line. I kept on saying as they're trying to convince herself that Hisara family only has one child. Shinya, and kept on taking care of me. For half a year until I graduated, Machina was left alone for herself. Left alone for herself in her dark room. The Fuji let that relax me. Of course, graduation ceremony was partially a fault, but I was naive myself. And once I thought that was a goddess, even though it was a stretch. How could I think that Machina wouldn't say anything again? How could I think I'm her level?
And so, Shinya, your teacher decided to move you two to the same class.
What?
Machina shuddered. For the holiday table, for the first time in 6 months, Mother put her fake smile on.
Why is that so? What are you talking about? Does sister still want to attend school?
Machina, who didn't go to school for a whole year, probably couldn't pass the next grade. Mother, who fought Mother, who thought of her as of a bother, surprising parental duty, thought that she wants her daughter to graduate from school, so she signed her up for her second year.
What's so bad in that? You, Shinya, even she could go to school.
So said the father, who didn't understand anything, tried to make it look like he did.
Putting an older sister on the second year with a younger brother? What nonsense.
Father, teachers alike, are they idiots or what?
It's not the way to deal with it now.
What the hell? Not funny. I'm not going to nurse her.
Just refuse that straight, instead of saying anything about nursing.
No, not like that.
At that moment, Magna didn't drop her spoon, everything would be alright.
Pick it up, Magna. You dropped it.
What? Don't be silent. Not clairvoyant.
Or don't you hear me?
Dropped a spoon?
Mother says, pick it up yourself.
Listening to Mother's order, Magna slowly picked up the spoon. Dad pretended not to look.
Magna alone looks at Mother with a spoon in her hand.
Mommy, eat me.
The episode at the table breaks. Magna can't even eat by herself. Mother angrily hits the table.
Enough! You're so spoiled! Can't even eat yourself? You stupid! And to become such a klutz! You have a fine example before you. If you can't do anything, you should just watch Shinya and learn.
Yeah, you know, Mother. That was the one line that should have never been said.
Huh?
Magna's eyes shine like lenses.
Mother? Can I do something myself?
Of course! You're not a child, so if you don't understand something, copy Shinya! You won't bother anyone that way. That's enough.
Don't give her a goal. Don't teach her the methods.
This mechanism must not be started.
Ah, I see. I'll do so.
After that, the Sire family's history turns around to be a real mess. Well, and me. Whatever I did, nothing worked out well.
Oh no.
In high school, me and Maka started learning in the same class together. To be honest, I thought it couldn't get worse. This is repeating grade because of low attendance. This crest doesn't suit me. Father's poverty brought me misfortune here too. He didn't want to pay for our education, so he only allowed us to take exams in the local high school. Makina would surely drag me down. Can't even eat alone. Who would like such a girl? No one. We get deprived of human rights in school. Pride, physique, difference in grades. Not like it's a matter of course to blame you all on their sins. Makina has it all. She'll get bullied, no one will save her. But it's meaningless to save her. You save her and she's thoroughly rotten. And in the end, you only get more problems. If it wasn't for relatives, I don't think anyone could be kind to her. But high school life, begun with a headache about ostracism, appeared in fact beautiful. For the first month, Magna spared me her presence in classroom. This local high school had many acquaintances, and teachers remembered me from the good side. So I became a central figure of the class, found friends and trust. Sometimes a topic about my absent sister was raised, but I'm already used to avoiding that talk. Graduating from middle school to high school, Hisari Shinya made yet another great step. There was one thing that bothered me. Magna stopped leaving her room. Every time I felt a stare and turn around, Magna was always looking at me. It wasn't a day when our gazes didn't meet. I got irritated by that, and stared at her in return.
Yeah, that looks creepy as fuck, not gonna lie. Oh, that's horrifying. That's creepy as shit.
I'm wondering why was I looking at it then?
Well, you see, I just felt like it.
Before, she always fled, but now, during their unfriendly stare, she kept closely watching me. Not blinking like a camera. She kept looking at Hisari Shinya. In May, I realized that I'm uncomfortable with that. One evening, Dad was in an unusually good mood and was talking to Makina about all sorts of stuff. Something about successful work, thanks to Makina, something else. Not funny. Remember how we were sitting behind this same table when we were still kids? So Makina, I bought you a cage, but don't you want a bird? No, I have a cage. Why would I need what's inside?
Dad was happily smiling. I'm gonna ask to buy something. It's a rarity. Dad agreed to buy it. It's a rarity too.
Watching this scene from the side, alienated. Those are words, I finally got it.
Dad called Makina by her name. And Makina, not saying a word, is casually smiling in return.
Oh, likely ban evader. Man, crazy. Get the fuck out of here. Man, get out of here.
The relationship between Makina and Dad got strangely better. One Sunday when I came back after club activities, Dad and Makina were playing ball outside. They often went shopping. After bath, they were watching TV together.
Thanks, Shinya. Now Makina cheered up.
I was looking at Dad with a long-forgotten face expression. I didn't do anything. Makina cheered up because of me, she says. For some reason, I become disgusted.
You know, Makina, I actually wanted a son like you.
He happily patted Makina's head.
I swear, Makina's not a boy.
So disgusting, so nauseating.
Of course it is.
A completely isolated person becomes so normal again in just 1 month. How could daughter hated so much by her parents get along with them so fast? I didn't understand what's the most disgusting part of it at first. And so in June, Makina came back to school and nothing happened.
That time I started having nightmares. I opened my eyes with an indescribable feeling of occlusion. Time is at midnight, and lights are off. I look at the door, it's open a little. Surely, something is watching. Behind the door, darkness is much deeper than in the room. Uncovered, interrupted breath. That gap.
Oh, don't show it. Pupil like a camera. A creature made of eye alone.
Okay, I said don't have a CG of that, please.
From the outside, all of us with Makina looked like a friendly family. Makina was a bit by bit getting along with her classmates, making friends, cleaning her tainted name. Schoolgirl that wasn't coming to class is a weakling that is to blame, but schoolgirl trying to come to class again is a weakling that is to be defended. I ignored such a righteous sister, I've become the one to blame. As a good brother, I could only silently watch over Makina's rehabilitation. If I was completely disgusted with it, Makina peacefully, smoothly, become part of class, completely unlike her. Such a honestly average behavior was coming from a Makina I didn't know. I feel like spitting. Most of that can't get along with us people. Such an obviously forced smile, you can't get popular. It's too fake. Such a newcomer can't get other people's trust. Be too shallow. The one that I support, it can't be so simple.
What? She's who he used to talk to. Sarah-san. Even though she's a girl, she's like a guy. And again, she's nice to talk to.
Mark and I really like you.
Really? Isn't it the opposite? More like Shinakuna is like Makina-san. Some middle school friends are saying. Like Hisari Shinya has two bodies.
If you can't do anything, you should have just watched Shinya and learned.
Yes. I knew that without saying.
There was another me in the class. From the everyday habits to learning in grades, the manner of speaking, supporting the partner, and returning to yourself. General topics and personal likings that are scary to others.
The love that was mine. Really, I feel like spitting. Stop that!
Your life completely changed in 2 months.
From day to day, Makina's imitation kept focusing. Learned her detailed copying. From retelling to complete playback. She kept diligently imitating Hisari Shinya.
What for? I don't know.
head's working multitude times better than mine. You should just decide to act like me, for whatever reason. In the end, a perfect, better personality would appear. She just concentrated on imitating. Something was seriously wrong with her. Copying your idol's taste is fine. Then you get inspired by someone, and you feel like becoming just like that person. But for Makina, I'm just a person that happened to be close at the moment. Like a random passerby. Can you psychologically copy actions of someone like that? No interest, no respect? That can't be a goal. It's not worth the effort and time. Is it really a possible thought for a living being? The monster should have its own motives, own will. All I could do was swallow my discontent. Makita became a positive, reasonable, sane role model student. Nah, even though knowing how heinous she is, I just keep on playing friendly relatives with her. Completely useless effort. Without the balance kept on shifting every day. The year repeating loser was becoming a spotlight in class. Just like me. Being a leader among girls, was a leader among guys. It looked like we were a happy family. At home, though, there was only one spotlight. In just 2 months, his entire family completely restructured. Parents stopped looking at Shinya and started to see the happiness in Makina's smile. Every coming day, I felt it's becoming harder and harder to live there. Say, Shinya, can you give your room to your sister? Not funny. I won that room. Makina, after running away to storage room, can't just simply return there. Makina, are you free next weekend? Dad wants to go to that one place. Inviably honest, he was wearing a fake smile mask before. Now he's shamelessly spoiling her. Got enough of that family lunch. Enough to come back to my room. Wait, Shinya. Relax your right shoulder before sleeping, or your neck will get stiff in the morning. It's stiff in the morning. Is that so? Giving him parents' care, Makina tells me about Hisari Shinya's mind body feature that I didn't know about myself. That I myself didn't know about. I feel like I heard a shudder sound in her lifeless eyes. In response, I averted my eyes and rushed to my room. Not because I lost peace of mind from Makina's dominance. My room, which I was heartfully cleaning, becoming dirtier and dirtier. Today too, I ignored it and fell onto bed. Next morning, I woke up with a stiff neck, because I ignored Makina's warning. Well, of course. Good morning, Makina. Oh, is your neck stiff? You alright? Oh, good morning, Makina. Oh, is your neck stiff? You alright? During breakfast, it appeared that predicting even my ignorance, Makina woke up with a stiff neck. So she won't even, like... She's copying Shinya so perfectly, even if she knows how to not get a stiff neck, she'll still get a stiff neck because he has one. That's kind of fucking stupid. Because that's imitation is, but an aggression to original. Starting from second semester, Sarah Shinya's chair almost managed to drop me down. One day, my friend declined my offer to go for a walk. Said he got some urgent business to deal with. No time to play. He may reject my offers, but why not? It can happen to anyone. I didn't give him much thought and walked downtown for shopping when I accidentally saw Makina. What the hell? Thanks to whom faces my friends, rejected my invitation. We're shining with smiles. I want to remember what I felt back then. You were the ones who broke the promise. I'm right. I'm a victim in all possible ways. Rushed home right away. Because they noticed me, I'd feel ashamed. Hi, Shinya! I just accidentally met Makina there! Stop it. Excuses like that make it even worse. If you say those excuses, it'll only add to the cold.
What the? Think a little, come on. Okay, okay, Shinya, wanna come with us? I wanna think about it.
Be me, that would be like an avoided, but putting his nose everywhere would be
like an avoid. These sentences are starting to get fucking worse and worse. I've heard the translation is starting to fall apart, bro. Putting his nose everywhere loose. So with no friends. I flew into the room. Into my room. Shut the door and screamed. I feel like doing it. Not letting all that anger out on that meaningless cleanliness mess it all up. My self-esteem didn't let me do it. Stop. 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 I need to look for compensation. I didn't lose anything. No. Nothing. I'm gonna trip my own foot and roll down. Now it's best to just calm down. I can't seem to do it. So I got asthma now. My head starts aching. I almost fell from dizziness when the closed door opened. Sister. Makina enters. Treat to bed. Makina says emotionless in a messed up room. What do you want? To enter others' rooms without permission.
Yep, I just saw you. You ran away all of a sudden. Something happened?
Asthma disappeared. Dizziness was gone. Instead of that, I felt my brain being set on fire. I almost got smoke coming out of my ears.
What? How serious you are anyway?
This is bad. My throat burns. This is bad. I know what you're trying to say, but questioning me so much is unreasonable. I said it long ago. This monstrous creature, as soon as you know its true face, starts attacking people.
Serious about what? Did I do something to you, Shinya?
You keep doing it openly. What's that? Were you with Saito and others, sis? You're a girl. Why don't you just have fun with girls? Why? Why did you have to steal my friends? This can't be stopped. Irritated and probably scared. I can't stop my words.
Ah, so that's it, she says.
Close her eyes, and then Makina.
But Saito-kun called me himself. He says, Shinya is boring. He's not even special anymore. He said, if he is to choose between me and him, I'm more interesting.
Awkwardly chuckled. Like she's pitying me. That was really... That made me freeze for a second.
A sharp sound. Everything went white. Right face is on fire.
Makina didn't even yelp. She just limply falls on her butt.
My reasoning is crumbling. It's unpleasant. For the first time, I used brute force.
It was so apparent I felt nothing rolling. Felt like rolling time back.
Makina turned away and rubbed her newborn bruise on her right cheek.
She got quiet because she's surprised with little brother hitting her?
No. She... It can't be. Is smiling?
You're disgusting!
Makina's the weak one. I don't want swinging fists, but my legs are shaking. Makina's shoulders are quivering.
What are you laughing at? Shut up! What's so funny? You're crazy! Get scared like before!
Nothing's funny. Before I've thought of anything as fun.
Slowly raise her gaze.
Oh no.
Monster. With shining camera eyes. That's why I couldn't do anything as myself.
But yes, I try to take your place, Shinya, as it seems to be entertaining.
The first time in my memory, she laughed in joy. question that was tormenting me from a very childhood got an answer. I was so disgusting in her. It's so simple. Like, I cried, she got angry. But she never once rejoiced. Fun? Why? Scared I could only ask this. I started to beg her to stop this. Maybe she would have done so. Too late.
Well, it's funny of everyone this way. You can disappear, Shinya. I'll be Shinya instead. Because, you see, I'm better at being Shinya than you.
She can't be stopped anymore. To my right fist, red in Makina's blood. Don't laugh. Don't laugh, don't laugh, don't laugh. You're not the one everyone loves. You're not the one for whom everything goes well. Don't copy me. Don't move. What the hell? What the hell? You can't do nothing but copy me!
It sounded in the room. Akin hits the wall. A shelf falls down. Books drop on her head. Slight bleeding. But to the right, her eye would have been damaged. Oh, that destruction was continuing. Remember how Mother came back and bandaged Makina? Wounds on the face were minor. She was alright. There was no longer a place for me in the house. Dad scolded me. Makina stood up for me. I only got touched by sister's kindness. I only looked at the fallen shelf. It's the one we built together as siblings in our childhood. My favorite shelf. Tendency got even stronger. What came after that is obvious. Parents were charmed with Makina, and lost more friends. I became more and more scared of being cornered. I desperately fought to avoid that. But nothing worked well for me. Because Makina could do my actions better than me. Too good. Stopped understanding how I became successful before, and in the end, I was forced to learn from Makina. She was supposedly the one copying me, but now it's me who tries to catch up. Learn from her how to be Hisari Shinya's imagining. How to be Hisari Shinya she's imagining. I don't understand what I was like originally. The end came abruptly. The class I set my place in, I dropped myself because of a trifle matter. One morning, I came into class. Makina was giving out printouts. It was my responsibility as a class representative, not yours, I said. I raised my hand to Makina, just like at home. Why are you doing this? I said. The exact same phrase came back to me from everyone else. The next day, when I entered the classroom, my desk was thrown away. Who was the first to drop school? Well, doesn't matter. In the second semester, I stopped coming to school and I was sitting in my room. Everything was a mess there. A dirty ruin scheduled for demolition. Mother came in from time to time worried. Dad only came in once in the end. Makina. I think she was always in my room. I remember how Makina was before. Just like her, I was bearing the torture of time. Looking at nothing. Thinking of nothing. I think Makina was living just like that. So Hisari Shinya is deprived of any qualities of value. It's meaningless to copy him. Leave him alone. I can't do anything, and I'm good for nothing now. My parents were asleep. I was in the kitchen. When I was walking the hallway to the toilet and turn around, Makina was silently standing there, watching me, clicking with her shutters. His eyes kept watching me. Not person, but trash. Mechanic, cold voice said, "Hey, are you not going to do anything new?" I screamed and ran away to my room, closed my door. Under the blanket.
Mine is long broken. Those windows, shutters, isolate myself. My room is my darkness. Only light from under the door gets in. But she can see right through me. If I lock myself in the room, she watches my every move. Yes, it's always like that. Why didn't I notice it before? Fleeing to my room was a mistake. It's a cage. Every day I was under her watch. How? Something this monster can't do. I open the shutters now. There's a huge eye looking inside my room. No. No, no, don't stop! Makino was copying me, it was fine. There's nothing left to show her, my usefulness is gone. Makino always burns the books after reading them. So now, even when I hide so she stops seeing through me. You can't do it like that, Shinya. If you manage to cut your wrist like that, it only hurts. To do it properly, you wouldn't need to at least that hard knife you stole yesterday. Someone, help me. Except this room is inside her eyeball.
Oh. Okay, that got really fucking dark, okay? That actually makes me a bit uncomfortable. Okay. That actually makes me a bit uncomfortable.
In the end, it became apparent. I couldn't become Makina. Life without any thoughts can't be achieved with a soul. I was all cracked. It wasn't crumbling yet. I was afraid of Makina, and then I got tired from being scared and started thinking of a way out from this situation. To start with, can't do something so Makina leaves me alone. She was copying because I didn't save her from her classmates' bullying. It's her revenge. I say sorry, maybe she'll forgive me. I hoped. Got up from bed and talked to Makina, who was right here.
Why? I was never mad at you.
She says, fixing the broken shelf. Family voices coming from the kitchen.
Dad, maybe it's time to throw away that cage?
What do you want, Makina? But why do you want to throw it away? I thought you treasured it.
Nah, I never once treasured it. Sai was just a meaningless worm anyway.
And it's boring, to be honest.
I felt like killing her.
Locked body and constantly thieved soul reached the limit and broke it. What's with that everyday tone? Like everything's over. She stole Hisari Shinya, and no one cares now?
Yes. How naive I am.
Not revenge. Not being mad. She won't be touched by such humane emotions. It's meaningless to say sorry. She never had any feelings about me. So now she'll get... Now she'll get for it. If I become useless to her now, before that I'll avenge myself. Burning, indistinguishable determination. Well, fired up, waited for night, make sure it's past 2 o'clock, and started to look for a fitting tool. How lucky! Into a toy, there's a baseball bat in the cabinet. Toy, but made of steel. It's gonna hurt if you get hit with that. But it can't be helped. I rewrote everything that happened in my memory. Concentrated my hate. And tightly gripping the handle.
Huh. It's lighter than I thought. You now managed it like that.
Slowing my breath. Quietly, I opened the door. Now through the hallway. The kitchen, then to Makina's room. Yes, I had to do so from the start. I'm not weaker than her. If Makina is a girl, she gets hit with a bat so it hurts. Break her hand. At least, she'll think about it and understand it's dangerous to corner me. Enter the hallway. 4 steps after, I enter the kitchen. Lights are out. Kitchen is covered in darkness. No human presence. Some more steps. Kitchen is left behind. At the same time. other side of the kitchen before the open storage room door. Stood a sorry machina. Like in a mirror, exactly same time that I entered kitchen, Machina left her room. My hand, I hold baseball bat. In her hand is a sharpened, shiny knife. It was complete imitation. She knows Hisari Shinya's conscious state. She knows its limits. She's imitating Hisari Shinya. But a knife and a bat. My Shinya wanted to scare. Makina Shinya wanted to kill. Damn. Makina smiles in embarrassment. Heh. So I made a mistake in the end. Sorry, Shinya, you appeared to be smaller. That's when it happened, I guess. What was before me finally crumbled to dust. Can't defeat this. Do whatever I want, but my Hisari Shinya can't match her Hisari Shinya. Just didn't understand before. I'm already an empty old caterpillar cocoon. I have to be stepped on and forgotten. Oh.
Wait, what happened?
Beginning of 2001. My last story before I became to the clinic. Today was Makina's birthday. It wasn't even mentioned until last year. But now from dusk, mother and father were engrossed in preparation. From now to dusk, mother and father were engrossed in preparation. I locked myself in my room and I only pray for dawn to come. Hisari Shinya was long in Makina's ownership. Just has to wish for it, not disappear. Makina's birthday. Only resurrection of the one who was dead, but reborn as Hisari Shinya. Makina got live from the very morning. She called me to join in a lot of times. Said I should die with everyone, at least today. Not funny. Even in this room, I feel like disappearing from others' gaze. Down below in light. I met eyes with Makina, my heart will stop for sure. Come on already, Shinya. It's your sister's birthday. Kept on ignoring calls for me, and seemed like mother lost her patience. She opened the almost always locked door and entered my room, with any restraint to the very center of it. Where Makina is always standing, very center of the ruin. Why are you still sleeping? The room is a mess. When were you already... Become like your older sister? Boring. Hallway lights are blinding. If I close the door, they scold me. Go back to darkness. Mother's still here. You hear me? It's your sister's birthday today. Maka doesn't like that you're not there. She says she wants to celebrate it with you, Shinya. Boring. Makina. Mother's proudly saying her name. She's so boring. Why do you care about me? You're just dragging me out of bed to please Makina. Enough. Stop it. I don't want it. I'm sad to see Makina. See you so happily talk to Makina. I care about Makina so much. Come on. Sister's waiting for you. Please. Begging you, leave me alone! Push away. The side of the door, which was the uncle guest came in through. Push this Makina's pawn.
My back is itchy. Yeah.
The sound of hitting against the closed door. Sound of falling down on the butt. On my butt. Shinya? What are you? Angry mother at that moment when I thought it happened before. from Mother's neck, found the blood gushed forth, and sound of falling junk, light from the gap in the door. So I check on the situation. Right above the door, what did it appear there? Tilted was a shelf with a broken bracket. Stuff from it dropped on Mother. And in Mother's throat was a shining blade, which dropped on the floor, precisely slicing her throat. As to be said, it was beautiful. Blade fell vertically, but as it was funneled, caught Mother's throat with a sharp tip and sliced it through. Hey, Mom? No answer. Forced breathing sound. Sea of blood. Can't even say if she's alive or not. Shit, yeah, help. Don't understand like that, Mom. You could try to learn, say... You could try to learn, say ventriloquism. Look at the murder weapon. Knife. The one that was supposed to kill me. I had time to understand what that means when... What's with that noise? Did something happen? Ed's voice came from the hallway. Door handle turns. Mother's blocking the door. Dad forcefully opened the door. Still breathing, Mother's body rolled on the floor. Kayo? What scary image appeared before his eyes? Dad's reaction was a pleasantly fitting calmness. First thing first, he hit me. Standing dumbfounded, and then right away checked Mother's condition. Ripped her clothes and put them on her throat. Sounded it's dangerous to move her. And yelling at me not to move, and ran through the hallway. But it wasn't right. Dad wanted to call an ambulance as soon as possible. Ran through a narrow kitchen hallway to kitchen and he tripped over something and fell down. It sounded falling. Problem appeared later. I was waiting and waiting, but neither the sound of him getting up, nor the dinging sound of picking up phone wasn't heard. Silence. The only thing heard was Mother's breathing. Sneak out of the room and head towards the kitchen, next to a dinner table. The blade deeply stuck in his left eye, lay motionless Father's body. It's dangerous to walk with things like that, Shinya. On the side of the table, before the phone, a single drop of blood on her clothes, standing smiling mocking her. As she said, things like that, I look at my hand. It's gripping a knife. Nervously, I relax my grip. Stained blade gets stuck in the floor. Sister. What happened? Can't even think about it. Did Father die? Is he on the brink of death like Mother? That's all I'm thinking about. Sister. Stupid me. So I had some hope left. Wanted to explain the situation somehow. Call the ambulance, but... Good job, Shinya. So, when did that thing hit Mother? Red eye or jugular vein? I realized. This here? This talking to me? It's the one that gave Father the decisive strike. Do you not hear me? I'm asking, what's up with Mother? The shell fell, right? I didn't see it. At least tell me about it. What did it pierce? Red eye? Or the throat? I'm getting sick. No point asking Makina what happened. She's interested in whether Mom is alive or dead. She's so interested in where the knife hit her. How do you know this? What if Mom and Dad was defeated by terror? Doesn't matter. The shelf, not the knife that shouldn't have been there. Not the motionless dad. It's no point to ask for any of it. It's not apparent anyway. But why? Why does she know how... Not so precise what happened to Mother? What's with you? It's just math and physics. I know the size and mass of Mother's body, her step length, put it all in the formulae, and the result is obvious. What were you doing in school all the time, Shinya?
Ah, so that's how it is. My room wasn't organized by me. She's the one that arranged everything so it happens. Messy floor, broken light, the place from which she was talking to me. Everything was arranged so that she can reach her goal. She just had to wait for when all conditions were met today. Today wasn't a time for decisive actions. And she, who didn't care when to start, was waiting for me to flip the switch. She kept waiting for Asari Shinya to attack his mother. But why? Stop that. I decided to do it as a gentler method. I'm small. I'm not ready to kill. You know better than I do. Oh, I see. Mother has a life-threatening wound. Well, the difference between life and death was about whether she stood on her feet or fell on her butt. I tried to add the weight as much as I could, but in the end, the distance was depending on you two. Both you and Mother were unlucky. I was a bit weaker. Mother stood a bit steadier. The room wasn't in a mess. She wouldn't have fallen? You know what, Makina? All that said, you didn't leave Father lying there into his luck. Yep. What's with Mother? I understand. Now it's time to go on. Makina turns and picks up the phone. What are you doing? What? I'm calling the police, obviously. We have such a terrifying occurrence here. I'm failing to understand that. Police, not ambulance? After that, Makina would be arrested. After all, this tragedy was arranged by... Got it, Shinya? Got it? Shinya, your clothes are stained with blood. That's a problem. Also, as a fact, in a sorry family circumstances half a year ago, you physically assaulted me a couple times. Narrowness of thinking from self-inflicting damage. From panorama, used fasciae lens. I felt dizziness. My body tried to part with my consciousness. It's like I've lost my mind. Makina is pressing the buttons. You know who would they think did it? Oh, here. Hello, police? I can't allow. A bat. For some reason, the bat was conveniently lying in the kitchen. I'll be doing what I couldn't do that night. Hand. At least a hand, yes. At least her hand. I had to break back then. I swing the bat with all I have. Full swing at Makina's right hand, gripping the phone. Amazing world-whipping sound. Phone dropped down. I break it too. I was falling, I swore myself with the bat. Saved. Can't call police now. Police has to come for her. I could stop her in time. Oh. Huh? Broke a phone? The broken hand. Makina moves to the balcony with light steps. You're so scary, Shinya. Don't want police to be called that much? Oh. That's copyrighted music too. That's fine though, it's good. And now, farewell. Finally release your chair. She opens the door. Despite the darkness of the inside, outside is a beautiful sunset. Red balcony. Just like back then when she saw a ghost. But don't worry, Shinya. But don't worry. Shinya will be isolated from society. But I'll continue Shinya's way of acting. Yes. She'll take Hisao Shinya's place and not be forgotten by everyone. And one person can sit in a chair. For Makina to sit there, the weak, pitiful, but still owning the chair, I had to be disposed of first. Sister.
I don't know myself what I want to say. I want forgiveness. I want help. I want to believe that this is my sister. And this chuckling in the end. Stupid. Bye-bye, Shinya. The sigh looked like she was running away from me, laughing, jumping from the third floor's balcony. That, I think I need a break, bro. Holy shit. Jesus Christ. You know who that is? Damn. That was fucked up. Like, good lord. Oh, this is messing with me in ways I maybe don't want it to. Good god. It's certainly one of his darkest works. Holy shit. God damn. Well, chat, hope you all enjoyed. So I'll keep it brief. Have a good evening or night, wherever you are in the whole wide world. And hope to see each and every one of you, same time, same place, next time. Right? Alright, chat. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.